People in places like West Memphis don't like anything that stands out, including intelligence and beauty. If a woman is smart enough to take care of her body so that she doesn't become a sexless mom, she will get looks of hatred from the local women. They will cast the evil eye at her as they help themselves to another plate of biscuits and fried pork chops. If a man is a little too intelligent for the taste of the locals, he will soon find himself ostracized. Most don't have either the self-discipline or the self-respect to better themselves, and they despise anyone who does, because it makes them feel small and inadequate. Unless you want to be the target of resentment, you have to keep your head down and shuffle your feet along with the rest of the herd. The one thing above all else that is not tolerated is magic. Any trace of wonder or magic must be snuffed out at all costs. Then, instead of mourning its faults, they'll pat themselves on the back. Nothing can be mundane enough to suit the herd. Bland country faces and bland country places. When I was a kid, somehow a story started circulating in West Memphis. I can only guess at its origin, but something about it horrified me. In fact, the whole town was pretty on edge. People were claiming to have seen a dog with a man's head. It was rumored to have escaped from a traveling carnival freak show that had come through the area. A preacher swore that he spotted it looking through a window of his house. Neighbors stood on their lawns in the evening with the same facial expressions they wore when scanning the skies for tornadoes. "Get back in the house," they would snap at the children, who were drawn out by the hovering sense of excitement. I'm certain I wasn't the only one who began having bad dreams about the dog man. Eventually, people seemed to forget about it and faded from the conversations. The feeling never left, though. A vague atmosphere of dread and dangerous fear seemed to hover like a fog for the next decade. It was a sort of fear that robs people.